test of convergency, there would be various other test of convergency of a series. First test of convergency, that one is relied on definition of series, that as we have mentioned, that how we can define a series. So in order to define a series, we have to come up with a sequence. So we are having a sequence of real numbers. Generally, we are discussing, when we discuss about calculus, it is always dealing with function of real number or real group function of real number. So we are having a sequence, and we had already seen that from this sequence we can define a sequence partial sum that we denoted by xk, and it actually it is equivalent to say that it is again a sequence of partial sum, and it is equivalent to say that it is actually talking about series. I am talking about equivalency here. So series of the series where term is coming from the given sequence xn, and here n varies from 1 to infinity. Here the starting index n equal to 1, it may vary, it may be 0, it may depends upon, it is very much dependent on what kind of nth term you are taking. Okay. So this is the overall concept of series. In introduction of series, we had already discussed all these. And if you talk about convergency of a series, and then convergency of the definition of convergency of series is directly borrowed from convergency of the corresponding sequence of partial sum. And based on that, we had already established convergency of two series. One was two series. It was two type of series. One was two series. So two series is having a very specific form, that where we say that n term of the series is what, of the form of 1 by n square. So two, this one is the two series. So we had already seen that this series is convergent from the definition of series, that from the convergence of sequence of partial sum, we had already seen that this series, this two series is convergent where n varies from 1 to infinity. Also, we had already seen that another series, that generalization of two series, was P series. So you call it P series. So in the denominator, you just replace the exponent of n 2 by any positive integer, positive real number which is greater than 1 here. And when P is greater than 1, then we talk about this series with n term 1 by p to the n to the power p. It is convergent if p is greater than 1, and it is convergent. This is series would be convergent. So we had already seen, in short, I will write to convergent, CGT convergent, and in this series will divergent if you take p less than equal to 1. Then in that case, series would be divergent, and divergent word we DBG simply we will write it. Okay, divergent, series will divergent. So that we had already discussed. I will discuss one more series, and we will talk about convergence of that series based on sequence of partial sum. So when we are saying sequence of partial sum, simply we are saying that we are trying to discuss or define convergence of a series based on the definition of series. Okay, so that is the approach. Here we will discuss, after that we will discuss other comparison test. So first I am calling it here again recap of test of convergence based on sequence of partial sums. Then we will discuss about comparison test and limit comparison test. These are two basic series tests which are not involving sequence of partial sum. It will directly establish the convergence of series in a related term, that in comparison term, that means there would be other series, two series, one of them will decide convergence of other, and about one series we will have idea of convergence. Based on that, we try to come up with what would be convergence of other series. So such kind of comparison would be there. Okay. So coming to that first part, that as a recap of test of convergence based on sequence of partial sum. So I am taking today one more interesting kind of series, that we are calling it alternative harmonic series. So generally we had already seen that during the definition of series, this series where nth term is defined by 1 by n, that series happens to be divergent series. So we had already discussed this one, and the divergency of this series was discussed through divergency of corresponding associated sequence of partial sum. We had already seen the divergency of this series. So here this series also, another name of this series, we can call it harmonic series, because it is coming with respect to harmonic progression. So this series is a divergent series. Simply you can write it, if you try to find sum of this series, it would be equal to infinity. That's why, that is the meaning of divergency of this series. Okay, now we are taking another series, that one is in nature of alternating. There would be alternative sign. So how alternative sign we will get it? That means we are taking a series where nth term happened to be 1 by n. Apart from that, there is a term minus 1 to the power n plus 1. So easily you can say, if you try to expand this series in the open form, then series would be of the, if you take n equal to 1, what you will get? Anyone? What if you put n equal to 1? What would be first term? 1, it would be just 1. 1 by 1 is 1. What would be next term? Minus 1 by 2. Likewise, you have to keep on taking other terms. It will be what? Alternative sign. Their terms would be of alternatively positive and negative. It will keep on going up to infinity. So if we talk about sum of this series, then sum of the series, what is the sum of this series? Directly we can't say. It would be something around log 2. Someone had already answered that technique. Till now we haven't discussed that technique. Is based on other concept from calculus. Other concept from calculus. That's why we'll discuss how to find sum of this series later. We will find it. Right now we talk about convergence of series. So if you are willing to establish convergence of series, how we can do that? Again, we have to come up to definition of series that coming from sequence of partial sum. So we have to define here sequence of partial sum. So again, we are taking a specific kind of subsequence of natural number, and that nk equal to twice of k, that twice of k, okay, odd and even, that means even terms are coming here. So with respect to that, we can claim that corresponding partial sum x to k, it would be bounded below by zero. First criteria, it would be bounded below by zero. So we need to establish this one directly. Definitely it would be greater than zero, but how it is greater than zero? So we have to prove it through either mathematical induction or through some intuition. We have to prove it. And how we will prove it? And another, we will see it that for next, another sequence we are taking odd. So it is containing only odd number of terms. So if you try to look into this subsequence of natural number, what kind of terms it would have? So it would have just terms like 2, 4, 6, and it will go on something like that. Okay, so this one is the one subsequence, and if you take collect just even odd terms of the natural number, then you will get another subsequence of natural number. I am telling here it is subsequence. So again, this subsequence is infinite in number. It is not like that. So it will go something like that. So even it is going something like that, and you can say that it is again a subsequent infinite subsequence. So with respect to this subsequence, we are defining corresponding partial sum as twice of k plus 1. How it would be? It would be just equal to this s2k plus 1 by 2k plus 1. Anyone would comment over that, how it is coming? Do you face any problem in order to see this relation? Anyone? Yeah, geometrically, if you try to visualize that, there is what nth term it is talking about 1 by n. Definitely, it is just going closer to 0, and there is no issue. But here, it is not just about the sequence. Here, it is about the series, sum of the series, where it will be, what would be sum of the series. Sum of the series, there are various terms. one term, second, there are infinite term, infinitely many terms. So we have to sum up whether that sum of those infinitely many terms, whether it is a finite number or not. Like here also we can see that 1 by n is also approaching to 0 when n is approaching to infinity, 1 by n. So that 1 by n is having the same criteria. But what is the situation that if you sum all those terms, like you will see that 1 by n, that means it is like a plot, 1 by x, it is coming like this way. So here if you take n equal to 1, 1 by n equal to, it would be 1 by 1 equal to 1. Then next if you take 2, 1 by 2, it would be here likewise. So that means you can see that term is approaching to infinity, 0 when n is approaching to infinity. N we are taking along horizontal axis, and an or xn we are taking along vertical axis. So definitely it is a decreasing, terms are decreasing as n is approaching towards infinity, term is decreasing. But decrease, that decrement of term, it is not guaranteed that the series will converge, or the sum of the terms of the sequence would be a finite number. That one is not guaranteed. Same situation is here also, it is coming here, it is what, there is a oscillation, it would be oscillation. Like here if you talk about, try to interpret the term of this series, it would be also like it vary from between minus 1 and 1, you can say that. Like say here 1 would be here and minus 1 would be here, minus 1. So something plot would be, oscillation would be there, here oscillation is there, it will go up to infinity. So oscillation, so both sides, so terms coming both sides. So we have to see that whether this sum is a finite number or not. So how we can prove that? If we are able to prove that corresponding sequence of partial sum is convergent, then our job is done. So that's why we are just focusing on sequence of partial sum. So I told that we just define x twice of k, and we are claiming that this quantity would be greater than 0, and again we are claiming there are two claims. One claim is this one, another claim is this one. The second claim is very simple, it is directly coming from the definition of this partial sum. We know that after this 2k terms, next integer would be what? It would be 2k plus 1. 2k plus 1, that's why x2k is coming, and the last term would be what in the series, in this in the process of defining this partial sum with respect to suffix 2k plus 1, last term would be this. So that's why we are writing it x2k plus 1 is equal to s2k plus this last term. So that's why there is, so from here we can easily claim that monotonicity, we have to establish that monotonicity of sequence of partial sum in order to apply monotonous convergence of sequence. So just we are doing same thing. So here first criteria is that whether this series is, this sequence of this SN is bounded or not. Here XK, right, XK. This XK is bounded or not. So we have to look for that. So if you try to see this X twice of K, the how we are writing, we are putting bracket like this way, bracket like this way. We are putting bracket like bracket, bracket we have taken just starting from first term, and we are after that we are taking two consecutive terms and putting bracket. Then we can easily see that 1 minus 1 by 2, it would be greater than 0 or less than 0. Anyone? It is greater than 0. Yeah, it may look simple, just but you have to just understand why it is. Again, same, you take 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4, again it would be greater than 0. Likewise, 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1, it would be greater than 0. So what we observe, if you try to see x twice k, then it is what, talking about sum of positive real numbers. So what is sum of positive real number? Is always positive due to compatibility property of real number with order. So okay, order property is having compatibility with addition. So that's why from there we can claim that x twice of k is actually sum of positive real number, and hence x twice of k is greater than 0. So that's why it is very much easy to see the proof of this. Now next we are trying to see what is the whether x twice of k is bounded above or not. Bounded below, we have already seen that whether this one is for next term, whether it is bounded above or not. So what we do, we leave first term and after that we put bracket the two conjugated term. So what we observe, so what would be this quantity, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3, again it would be positive, this would be again positive, but we are taking negative sign. So what we do, in one case we subtract these quantities from 1, these quantity from 1. So here actually everywhere negative would be here, here also negative would be here, here negative would be here. So negative, we are subtracting from 1. So overall, if you try to see, if you put all these things in a bracket, then so these are positive quantity. So something positive quantity you are subtracting from 1, and hence we can say that this x twice of k plus 1, it would be always less than 1. Why? Because we are subtracting something, something epsilon. You can say that something epsilon plus from 1, that means we are just coming left side of 1. 1 is here and left, so we are coming left side of 1. So we can say that this quantity is greater than, less than 1. So we are having infinity third. Just focus on infinity 1, 2 and 3. What we observe? Anyone? What we observe? Now I establish three inequality. One is this one. It is saying that which one? This third one. We smartly put bracket in such a way that we leave first term. A rest of two conjugate term we took in together. After that we are taking a bracket. Okay, we are taking negative outside and putting everything behind the bracket. So this quantity is what? It is greater than 0. This quantity would be also greater than 0. This quantity would be also greater than 0. So these are very small number. These are very small number. So if you are adding the small number, then addition of those small number would be also small. In that sense, what we do actually, so remember here it is a finite, it is not like infinite situation here. We are having a finite situation. So you can say that sum of a small number happens to be again a small number. That small number we are subtracting from 1. So what is happening, that we are subtracting some small number from 1. That means we are coming left side of 1. And that left side of 1, what does it mean? Simply we say that this quantity would be what, less than 1. This x, so x of here we say that x twice of third is talking about bounded above and first is talking about bounded below. And what is second? It is talking about the something here as well. What does it talk about? X twice of k equal to x twice of k plus this term. So simply it says that also, I am writing in again in separate. It is saying that x twice of k is twice of k plus 1. It is greater than x s twice of k. Is it clear? Because some positive quantity is here. Okay, so that's where. Now from this three, if you try to write in together, then you observe that this kind of inequality, you observe that. So at hand you can say that x k is monotonically increasing first criteria. This sequence is monotonically increasing. Second, this sequence is bounded. So what does, no, it would be not like that. This one is first is different, that's an odd or even criteria I come up with. Odd or even, smartly you have to do that. Okay, so that there would be issue, you will face one remaining term would be there, you can't pair up. you can't pair up, there would be issue. Here, that's why pairing, how it is happening? We have taken twice of k plus 1, that is odd number of terms. So 2k terms we bring together and one term, that first term we are leaving it. So that's why pairing is happening. Pairing, you have to focus on pairing, that conjugative. Okay. So here simply we can say that that sequence xk is monotonically increasing, first criteria, and second criteria is sequence, every term of sequence is bounded. That means bounded below and bounded above. So from the monotone convergence theorem, actually we can say that the sequence of partial sum xk, it is convergent. That means limit of this one exists. That from monotone convergence it is coming directly, it is convergent. And later we will see that what is the limit of this one? Limit of this one is log 2. So right now I am not discussing how log 2 is coming, because there is a need of another concept that will directly come from Taylor's series. So I will discuss that time. Okay. So simply we can say that this alternating harmonic series, or it is convergent. It is convergent. Okay. That we have already again discussed with the help of definition of series. So it is again coming from the definition of series. Okay. So now we will discuss about some specific test, that these are really interesting and these are independent of those things. Here there is no need of again recalling sequence of partial sums. Independently you can deal with. So two kind of test we will discuss it here. First, it would be comparison test. What does it say? So suppose we are having two sequence xn and yn. There are two sequence and both are sequence of real numbers. Sequence of real number. Okay. And suppose there exists a natural number k such that the sequential terms xn, all these terms are greater than equal to 0 for n greater than equal to, after, that means after leaving first k minus 1 term, rest of term are greater than equal to 0 first. Okay. And second, it is saying that every term of xn is less than term of yn. This is the second. So two infinity we observe it here, after n greater than equal to n, that means after leaving first k minus 1 term, rest of terms are following these two infinity. Okay. So that is the condition for two sequence what we are putting. Then we will talk about corresponding series, convergence of corresponding series. So what will happen, that if you define with respect to this sequence, if you define a series, corresponding series would be summation of xn, n varies from 1 to infinity, and corresponding to sequence yn, we will define another series yn, summation of yn, n varies from 1 to infinity. Then remember that we are giving name. So what is the name of this series? If you see infinity, then this series you can call it inner series, because every term of this series is less than series defined by yn. So you call it, this series is inner series. And what is the name of this series? Anyone? It is an outer series. Yn, we will call it outer series. Why? Because every term of yn dominates the term of xn. That's why we are saying that it is outer series. Okay. So two terminology has been introduced. Now, what here through this infinity, what we observe, we can observe like this way. The convergence of outer series, if suppose the outer series with respect to this sequence, if outer series is convergent, then convergence of outer series implies convergence of inner series. Convergence of inner series, it is very much practical. You can see that if outer series is convergent, outermost is convergent, by default you will see that you will get limit of the sequence of corresponding sequence of partial sum. Okay. So that's why convergence of outer series will implies convergence of inner series. Second result says that divergence of inner series, if something divergent from innermost, then what will happen? It will also say that outer would divergence. So divergence of inner series would implies divergence of outer series. That is the comparison test. These two are the comparison tests. So based on this, we will try to, if one series is given somewhere, then we try to come up with another series that would find a comparison result like this way. That series would be simple. So this one is all about comparison series. Now we are taking another comparison test that we are calling it limit comparison test. So what does it say that? So suppose we are having two sequences xn and yn, and we are taking ratio of each term of these two sequences, and we are finding limit of that when n tends to 0. So that limit we denoted by r. Okay, this r is the limit of ratio of these two terms when n is approaching to infinity. Then what we can say that suppose this limit r is non-zero, then we can claim that both the series is having same nature. That means if you try to come up with the idea that this series, corresponding series, summation of xn is convergent, then you will claim that yn would also converge. If you come to know yn is convergent, then xn will also converge. And like vice versa, if you come up with one of the series is divergent, then other would diverge. So that thing we will see it here. Simply, I would like to say that both will have the same characterization. Now suppose if this limit r is 0, in that case what will happen, that convergence of yn will imply convergence of xn. Actually, in case of r equal to 0, this will be just comparison test. It will be converted into comparison test. Anyone comment how it will be converted into comparison test? Anyone may comment over that? If r equal to 0, then this limit comparison test is nothing, just comparison test. Anyone? So when r equal to 0, what you observe? You observe that, so not yn, actually when r equal to 0, it simply say that limit of xn by yn equal to 0. Then just apply the definition of limit. What does it say that? That means for epsilon, a given epsilon, there exists a natural, sorry, for epsilon, universal quantifier would come here. For a given epsilon, there exists a natural number k such that n greater than equal to k implies yn by xn by yn minus 0 is less than epsilon. And we know that here we have taken we have taken these x and yn are all positive real number. So if you take modulus, modulus would be equal to just this ratio. So you can say that, and you, if you subtract from 0, there would be no change. So you can say that yn xn by yn is less than epsilon, and from here it implies that xn is less than epsilon time yn. So anyhow, if you take corresponding series and if you multiply by this constant, epsilon constant, then convergence will not affect. So anyhow, you can say that here yn is playing like outer series and xn is playing like inner series. So convergent of outer series always implies convergence of inner series. That's why if r equal to 0, it leads to comparison test. So that's why I told you. Now we will see some application of these two tests, comparison test and limit comparison test. So what are those? So here we will have one example. We claim that we are having series 1 by n square plus n. Okay, and we are claiming that this series is convergent. We don't want to apply definition of series, so that means sequence of partial sum. Just we will try to come up with some comparison test. So easily we can visualize here 1 by n square plus n, it is less than equal to 1 by n square. You can easily see this infinity. Easily you can come up with this infinity, and with respect to this we will have series. Inner series would be 1 by n square plus n as inner series, call it inner series. And what would be outer series? 1 upon n square. So that would be outer series. And we had already seen that what kind of series this one? This one is 2 series. And we 2 series. And we had already seen that this series is convergent. So simply we can claim that if outer is convergent, that means convergent generally we denote it by that series is less than infinity. So if outer is convergent, it automatically implies that inner is convergent. Outer is convergent, then it implies inner is convergent. That is the concept. So here the outer series is convergent, simply it implies that the corresponding inner series is convergent. That is the concept. Now we will take another example, that 1 by n square minus n plus 1. So if you try to come up with this series, how we can find application, how we can find one associative series which will have some infinity result. So again we can see it here like this way. You can come up with one inequality like this way. Here you can't take it 1 by n square, then it would be false. For few n it would be false. You can check it like this way. If you check it for n equal to 1, n equal to 1, what would be this quantity? It would be just 1. Okay, but 1 by n square would be 1. If you take n equal to 2, if you take n equal to 2, what would be this term? 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. What we observe it here? It is just reverse. 1 by 3 is greater than 1 by 4. So simply we can say that this term is not bounded above by 1 by n square, but this term is bounded above by 2 by n square. This inequality, it would be bounded by 2 by n square. So that's where we come up with. Again, we can say that 2 is a constant. So here we can say that, yes. Again, we can say that this series is inner series and outer series is 2 by n square, and 2 is what? Constant. 2 is constant. So 2, you can take it out from the summation. So you can write it like twice of 1 by n square, because 2 is constant. So constant means constant with respect to n. So that's way. So and this one is a convergent series. And what does it say? It says that outer is convergent series, and hence the corresponding inner will converge. That is the criteria. Okay. So here you can write it twice of is convergent. Simply it implies the convergent of inner series. So it is just an outcome of comparison test. These are very simple result. Now we will try to see limit application of some limit comparison test for this same class of series. Then you will say that this limit comparison test, it work really better than the comparison test. How? So come up with another series 1 by n square. Okay, and we are already having 1 by series with respect and whose nth term is 1 by n square plus n. So divide the define the ratio xn by yn. So if you simplify it, what you will get, you will see that xn by yn is equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by n. Okay, and when n is approaching to infinity, this quantity is approaching to 1. That means this one is non-zero limit of this ratio. So here we can simply claim that the both series will have the same nature. That means if one is convergent, other would also convergent. And we know that 1 by n square is convergent. So we can, with limit comparison test, we can say that the corresponding series is also convergent. So similarly, if you come up with this series, then here there you have to be very careful in order to define infinity. Here you don't need to do that. Here just you have to find the ratio. Find the ratio of xn and yn, and from there you will see that this ratio is converging to 1, and 1 is a what? It is a non-zero real number. And from here easily we can claim that we know that series with nth term 1 by n square, it is convergent. So easily we can claim that this one is also convergent. So you can easily see that this test, it looks more reliable or more simple with respect to comparison test. That time you had smartly handled that inequality. You have to come up, you have to justify. Simply you can't take 1 by n square, that this inequality, you have to handle it carefully. So this quantity would be greater than, less than equal to 2 by n square. It is not equal, less than equal to 1 by n square. So that here definitely this inequality is more complex than finding this limit, more complex than. So that's why limit comparison test is much better than comparison test. Now you will take few more examples. Now I am asking a question. Can you say that whether this series is convergent or not? Anyone? Yes, series is coming like here 1 by a square root of n plus 1. I have written here convergent, it could be actually divergent. We'll see it here, because in P series test we had already mentioned that a series is convergent when value of P is greater than 1. What is the value of P here? So we have to define. So it is something look like it is something look like 1 by a square root of 2. And what is P here? P is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is less than 1. I had already told that if P is less than 1, then corresponding series would diverge. So that's why divergence, it is not convergent. So it will diverge. So we come up with another series xn, and we try to define here ratio. We try to define here ratio. So again, if you define ratio, then where does it converge? It will converge to something wrong. Word came here. Leave all this. So here this ratio is converging to 1. So again I have told that if ratio is converging to a number, then both this series will have the same characterization, same nature. And we know that easily we can say that this series, it is divergent from P series test, because here P equal to 1 by 2. So from there you can claim that the corresponding series is divergent. So here divergency of this series with n term 1 by a square root of n implies the corresponding series is divergent. Same characterization from limit comparison test. Likewise, if you come up with this series, can you say that this series is convergent or divergent? Anyone? What would the corresponding the suitable series which will get a comparison with this series? Okay. So we try to come up with a series like 1 by n square, and we try to see comparison of this 1 by series with term 1 by factorial n with n square. Do we see any comparison? So comparison, we can see it like here. So take ratio and just simplify this ratio, and you will come to see that the ratio is less than 1 by n minus 2. And if you take n limit as n tends to infinity, it will approach to 0. So simply what is happening, that what is the outer series in this case? Yn would be outer series, and yn is convergence. So from there the convergency of series 1 by n square, it will imply the corresponding series is convergent. So that is the concept it is coming here. Okay. So few things you have to establish, regarding limit comparison test, smartly you have to handle. So it is really interesting from the various perspective to establish convergence of a series. Okay, other things we will discuss in next class. And anyone is having any question, you can ask. Yes.